How to draw true shape of the section. Lesson number 8. Projections of solids if the section plane is parallel to HP. Projections of solids if the section plane is parallel to VB. Projections of solids if the section plane is inclined to HP and perpendicular to VB. Projections of solids if the section plane is inclined to VB and perpendicular to HP. Lesson number 10. Draw the sectional front view, sectional top view, sectional side view, and true shape of the section. So here, in sections of solids, we want to learn some important terms. One is front view. Already you know. Second is side view. Third is top view. And fourth is sectional front view. Sectional front view is nothing but a front view which involves as a section. That is sectional front view. Fifth is sectional top view. So a top view which involved as a section. Six is sectional side view. So a view which involved a section is called a sectional side view. Seven is true shape of the section. True shape of the section. Why? Because if any line is inclined to HP or inclined to VP, you should not give the true shape. That's why whenever the section plane is inclined to HP or inclined to VP, then the section is viewed in the true shape of the section, especially you want to draw an extra view for this purpose. So, front view, side view, top view, already we know in orthography projection. In sectional front view, sectional top view, sectional side view, these are the three important terms which are added to extra with projections of solids. So, sectional front view, sectional top view, sectional side view, true shape of the section. So, here we want to consider as, first of all, first type of problem is, section plane is parallel to HP. Section plane is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. So in this case, when section plane is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP, first you want to take XY line. So here, in this case, you want to apply a section plane in this way. So suppose the section plane is applied at front view side, it is indicated by vertical trace. Plus section plane is represented as line, two dots, line. So this is sectional plane at front view side. Once you want to apply the sectional plane in the front view side, what we get the top view, this is called a sectional top view. This is sectional top view. Here you want to get sectional side view. So this is front view. This is sectional top view. This is sectional side view. Here true shape of the section is not necessary. Why? Because when section plane is parallel to HP or parallel to VP, in this case, sectional top view or sectional front view, it gives the true shape. But whenever you want to go, second type of problem, sectional plane is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. In this case, this is XY line. You want to draw front view, you want to top view, you want to side view. Afterwards, section plane is involved. So, since section plane is parallel to VP, so this is indicated by HT. Why? Because section planes are represented by traces. HT is top view side. VT is front view side. When section plane is implemented at top view side, here you want to get the sectional front view. Here you want to get the sectional side view. So here sectional front view give the true shape. That's why here not necessary you want to draw the true shape. But when third type of problem, so sectional plane, sectional plane is inclined to HP. Inclined to HP and perpendicular to VP. Suppose in this case, see, remember that here the XY line, here you want to draw front view, you want to draw top view. Whenever you want to apply, sectional plane is inclined to HP. So this is sectional plane. So VT, suppose it inclines so much of angle. In this case, here this is front view. Here you want to get sectional top view. Here you want to get sectional side view. But sectional top view and sectional side view should not give true shape. Why? Because section plane is inclined. In this case, for sectional plane, parallel to sectional plane, you want to draw one more plane that is called as auxiliary inclined plane, nothing but AIP. This is represented by X2, Y2. Then suppose these are the sectional points, then you want to extend perpendicular lines. Here you want to get the true shape. So here you want to get true shape. So, but before the cases, section plane is parallel to HP, section plane is parallel to VP. In these two cases, the true shape, we should not get extra view. But on that case, true shape is involved in the sectional top view, and true shape is involved in sectional top view, my front view. But in this case, true shape is you want to draw one extra figure that is parallel to sectional plane. You want to take one more plane, you want to project on that plane all the points, then you want to take relative distances, then you want to get the true shape. So for in sections of solids problem, all of you remember that if any problem, they will ask either a front view or sectional front view or sectional top view or true shape. So based upon, once the problem is contained true shape, automatically in your mind you want to observe that the sectional plane is inclined to HP or inclined to VP. So this true shape, the word indicates that the problem, inside the problem, the sectional plane is inclined to HP or inclined to VP.